Hey, Michaela. Why should people help us save this?
Because I feel like a lot of places like this are starting to slightly diminish. I mean, if you look around this town, half of the lots and any like open space is slowly being like captured by people that want to build houses on them.
So, Michaela, tell us what the garden means to you.
It's a place where we get to learn how to take care of our environment. Nature?
Okay. Well, Michaela, what do you love? What do you love about our garden?
And nature. And that's all.
Okay. What else have we found in our garden?
Garden snakes.
Mm-hmm.
And caterpillars. And
Ethan, what are some of the things that you want to see in the garden?
Attract some like hummingbirds. To attract some butterflies and all kinds of birds. We can turn it into like the place there's kids.
Michaela, what's your favorite part about the garden? Can you tell us about the fort?
We built it out of like scrap wood, and it's on top of a car that was in the lot originally that was abandoned there. And
Michaela, can you speak on some of the transformations that happen in the garden over the seasons and kind of some of the stuff we did last year and what we're looking forward to again this year?
Even like moving to the house originally, I mean the lot was disgusting when we first moved here. It was weeds everywhere. And then like slowly we started to trim the lawn or trim all the stuff and pull the weeds. And then we started moving toys in here and then we started making it like a play space and then we decided to do the fort. And now it's like everything's a little bit more manageable.
The one thing you can do to help? Not litter. We're getting involved in
facebook.com/childinspirations. Or you can just search a Child's Inspiration Wildlife Discovery Garden. The world is cold, I will not have a lie.